On Advent Sunday, welcome to Charlton Benefice, St Luke's and St Thomas's churches. We sing our first hymn, Long Ago Prophets Knew. You're all very welcome to our service this morning, especially if you're here for the first time. Today is the first Sunday of Advent, and throughout Advent, we light one of the Advent candles each Sunday to mark our progress towards Christmas when we celebrate the birth of Christ, but also to remind us that we are drawing closer to Christ's second coming. So I'm going to light the first Advent candle. So let us pray. People of God, awake. The day is coming soon when you shall see God face to face. Remember the ways and the works of God. God calls you out of darkness to walk in the light of his coming. You are God's children. Lord, make us one as we walk with Christ today and forever. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. So, to prepare ourselves to worship God, let's say first of all our prayer of preparation, and then we'll go into our confession. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we might perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. When the Lord comes, he will bring to light the things now hidden in darkness and will disclose the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and to put on the armour of light. Now, in the time of this mortal life in which your Son Jesus Christ came to us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal. Through him who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We have our readings now. Ali is going to read from the Old Testament and then Peter from the New.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down, so that the mountains would quake at your presence, as when fire kindles brushwood and the fire causes water to boil, to make your name known to your adversaries, so that the nations might tremble at your presence. When you did awesome deeds that we did not expect, you came down, the mountains quaked at your presence. From ages past, no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God besides you, who works for those who wait for him. You meet those who gladly do right, those who remember you in your ways. But you were angry and we sinned. Because you hid yourself, we transgressed. We have all become like the one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a filthy cloth. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, take us away. There is no one who calls on your name or attempts to take hold of you. For you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us into the hand of our iniquity. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay and you are our potter. We are all the work of your hand. Do not be exceedingly angry, O Lord, and do not remember iniquity forever. Now consider, we are all your people. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have enriched in him, in speech and knowledge of every kind, just as the testimony of Christ has been enriched among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless in any day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him, you were called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Prepare the way of the Lord. Make his path straight, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. Alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. But in those days, after that suffering, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. Then he'll send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey. When he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on the watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn, or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Amen. Unborn babies don't wait. When their time comes to be delivered, there's nothing that can stop them. It's no use a pregnant woman saying, I'm not ready yet, when she goes into labour, because nothing can halt the inevitable process that ends with a new human entering the world. Newborn babies aren't good at waiting either. They fill their nappies, whether it's convenient or not. When they're hungry, they cry, whether or not the adults in the house are trying to get some sleep. We were all babies once, and so there was a time when none of us could wait. But as we grew, one of the things we learned was the art of holding on. Feeding on demand gradually gave way to eating at mealtimes. Filling a nappy whenever and wherever gave way to queuing for the loo. By the time we reached adulthood, we're used to the idea of waiting. We may not like the cold weather and short days, but we know we've no choice but to wait for winter to work its way through and spring to come again. So we learn to wait. This year has been a very long and painful exercise in waiting. Waiting to find out if the virus causing a stir in Wuhan would have any impact on us, remember that? Waiting for lockdown, waiting for the R rate to subside, waiting to see if people would recover, waiting for church to reopen, waiting for tests, waiting for a second wave, waiting for guidance, waiting for track and trace, waiting to know what tier we're in, waiting to know what Christmas will be like. Waiting. This year has reminded us big time of the struggle we have with it, why we don't much like it, how hard it is when we can't find distraction, when we can't fly away or fast forward, when all we can do is wait with few timescales and a mass of uncertainty. But about that day or hour, no one knows, said Christ. No one knows. How strangely relevant those words from this morning's gospel sound, no one knows. How we've craved knowledge that tells us exactly what's going to happen. How few plans we've been able to make. How little we felt in control of. This year has been a first for everyone. There were no experts to begin with. We were dealing with a set of circumstances we hadn't met before, and so we've had to learn together through mistakes, as well as by groping for a way forward. When he said, but about that day or hour, no one knows, Jesus was speaking of the coming of the kingdom, the impossibility of naming the time and place. But with the virus too, we've often been in the unsettling, scary situation where no one knows. We associate waiting with being passive or losing control. It can fill us with a sense of emptiness. It can sap our energy and steal away our motivation. I used to see that a lot when I worked in the hospital. No matter how kind nurses are, nor how efficient the doctors, being in hospital involves an awful lot of waiting for tests, for results, for bodies to heal or recover, for decisions to be made, for someone to visit, for a diagnosis, to go home, where we no longer have to wait for the actions of others. Waiting can feel like something that drains our hope and our faith that a better time will come. Waiting can be a space in which we start to doubt that promises will be fulfilled or that better times will come. Today is the start of the great period of waiting in the church's calendar, Advent. I believe Advent to be a profound gift from the church to the humanity, because it reminds us that waiting is an important, vital part of being human. Advent is the enemy of impatience, of the voice that urges us to fast forward to Christmas right now. Advent says, hold on, there are things to be done first. Advent is the enemy of us kidding ourselves we're in charge, of the voice that whispers, you have the right to know. Advent reminds us, walk by faith, not by proof. Advent is the enemy of distraction, of the voice that says, it's dark outside, so shut it out, draw the curtains, turn on all the lights. Advent says no, look at the darkness, because the one who hasn't looked darkness in the eye doesn't understand the need for light. Advent is the enemy of hopelessness, of the voice that says, eat, drink and be merry because tomorrow we die. Advent says no, your life has much more value than that. Spend time discovering your significance. Advent is the enemy of gloom, of the voice that says there probably is no light at the end of the tunnel. Advent says no, you may be in darkness now, but notice and recall the times you were bathed in light and travel in hope that the light will be here again. So what can we do in the waiting time? We can practice patience, get comfortable with just being and see what happens when we stop juggling and drop the balls. We can learn humility, learn how to say, I don't know God and I don't understand, but that's all right because you do know and you are in control. We can notice the darkness, the suffering, injustice and conflict that mars our world. We can reflect on the contribution we make to all that and be truly sorry. We can long for the light to come, long for Christ to be present in the places humans try to shut him out of. Discover how to yearn for Jesus as Jesus yearns for us. We can wonder that God loved us so much that he came himself into the mess and the pain and became one of us. we can recognize the depth, the breadth, and the intensity of that love, and get to know ourselves as one to whom that love is directed. And when we've spent the waiting time doing those things, I'd dare to suggest that we'll find hope. I dare to suggest that all we've discovered this year will direct the course of our lives from now on. A new focus, a new way of being, born of what we've found out about what really matters. As hard as it might be to regard this year as a gift, like Advent, it has changed us. So hold on, this too will pass. The light is coming. Let's be ready to walk into it as people prepared for the kingdom. Amen. So now we declare our faith in God. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So let us pray now for the church and for the world, and let's be thankful for God's goodness. Amelia will lead our intercessions.
We pray for the Church of Christ, for Bishop Carraway, the Bishop of Woolwich, the technical team helping to organise our Zoom worship, St John's Blackheath, Cholton United Reformed Church, and our friends at St Mary's Lye. Heavenly Father, we pray for all who have been working around the clock to make church easily accessible as possible for all to attend in one way or another. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for Her Majesty the Queen, the Prime Minister, the government and the MPs, the Diocese of Manicaland in Zimbabwe, the local councillors representing the ward in our benefice, people living in Gaza Strip where COVID-19 cases are spiralling and the hospitals are days away from being overwhelmed. We pray for the lands in which we were born. Today we remember especially South Africa, praying that peace and justice will reign there and that your church will thrive. Lord, we ask you to guide the people who are making the hard but important decisions about the world today. Give them strength to be able to carry out what is needed for the safety of everyone. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our local community, Cholton Manor School, all who benefit from the work of Greenwich Wellcare, the staff and volunteer fundraising group, Valley Hill Hub, all living at St Joseph's Court and the staff who work there. Father, we thank you that Jesus, our Good Shepherd, and is there to comfort and strengthen in times of suffering, sadness, pain and loss. Thank you that your rod and staff sustain and keep us, no matter what season of life we are passing through, and no matter how difficult the times become. We praise you, Lord, and you are our strong tower, into whose everlasting arm we flee for protection and safety. For you have pledged to uphold us with the right hand of your righteousness. Thank you that in the midst of suffering and distress, you have undertaken never to leave us nor forsake us. And when we face times of loneliness and isolation, you promise grace is sufficient to carry us through. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who are sick in body, mind, and spirit, and people who have asked for our support. People receiving and recovering from medical treatment, and those preparing for treatment. For the medics and scientists who work hard to produce a vaccine for COVID-19. Lord, we ask you to guide the people who are trying to help us in this difficult time. We ask you to offer them your hand and your heart so that they may feel that they know that they are making the right choices. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the recently departed and those who mourn their passing, including Molly O'Donnell, Patricia Coomber, and Vera Benjamin. Lord God, we pray for the souls who have recently returned home, and may they all be at peace now as they enter your kingdom and live on in spirit beside you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the families who mourn the loss of a loved one. Please keep and carry these precious people in their sadness and loss. Cover them with your great wings of love. Give their weary hearts rest and their minds sound sleep. Lord, lift their eyes so that they may catch a glimpse of eternity and be comforted by the promise of heaven. God of mercy, hear our prayer and make us one in heart and mind to serve you with joy forever. Amen.
In the tender mercy of our God, the day spring from on high shall break upon us to give light to those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let's offer one another a sign of peace. And then we sing our offertory hymn, Hills of the North Rejoice.
Thank you.
Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. Wise and gracious God, you spread a table before us. Nourish your people with the word of life and the bread of heaven. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. You are worthy of our thanks and praise, Lord God of truth, for by the breath of your mouth you have spoken your word and all things have come into being. You fashioned us in your image and placed us in the garden of your delight. Though we chose the path of rebellion, you would not abandon your own. Again and again you drew us into your covenant of grace. You gave your people the law and taught us by your prophets to look for your reign of justice, mercy, and peace. As we watch for the signs of your kingdom on earth, we echo the song of the angels in heaven, evermore praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord God, you are the most holy one, enthroned in splendor and light. Yet in the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, you reveal the power of your love made perfect in our human weakness. Embracing our humanity, Jesus showed us the way of salvation. Loving us to the end, he gave himself to death for us. Dying for his own, he set us free from the bonds of sin, that we might rise and reign with him in glory. On the night he gave up himself for us, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Therefore, we proclaim the death that he suffered on the cross. We celebrate his resurrection, his bursting from the tomb. We rejoice that he reigns at your right hand on high, and we long for his coming in glory. As we recall the one perfect sacrifice of our redemption, Father, by your Holy Spirit, let these gifts of your creation be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Form us into the likeness of Christ and make us a perfect offering in your sight. Look with favour on your people and in your mercy hear the cry of our hearts. Bless the earth, heal the sick, let the oppressed go free, and fill your church with power from on high. Gather your people from the ends of the earth to feast with Luke and Richard, Thomas, and all your saints at the table in your kingdom, where the new creation is brought to perfection
in Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, for we all partake in the one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I'm not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. We say together, most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation and share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him. And that we, with the whole company of Christ, may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen. The church of which we are members is not defined by the walls of a building, but by the body of Christ. In making our communion spiritually, we are joining with Christians everywhere to be nourished by the one who tells us, I am the bread of life.
Kyrie.
So let us pray. O Lord our God, make us watchful and keep us faithful as we await the coming of your Son, our Lord, that when he shall appear, he may not find us sleeping in sin, but active in his service and joyful in his praise. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Time for our notices. Tonight at 6 o'clock on Zoom and YouTube, so the same joining instructions as this service, we're having our Advent Carol service. So it's a mixture of Advent carols, images, drama, readings, prayer, and we're being joined, I'm delighted to say, virtually by our friends from St Mary's Lion in Rochester Diocese. So do please come along to that and use that service to help you in your Advent preparations. 6 o'clock tonight. Next week, of course, London comes out, the whole country comes out of lockdown, and London goes into tier two. That means that we'll still be here on Zoom and YouTube this time next week, but we'll also be in our church building, St Luke's and St Thomas's. So three services all at 10 o'clock. So please do come to one of those. It'd be lovely to see people back in church. It'd be lovely to see people here as well. So please do what feels best for you and right for you. And we'll look forward to welcoming you then. And as usual, after this service, we have our coffee morning and chat and Bible study. And I'd urge you to stay online because we're going to start that by just talking about all the different things we're doing for Christmas. If you have to go before that, then please visit our website, www.charlton.church, and click on the Christmas or Advent calendar tabs, which you'll see at the top. The Advent calendar becomes live on the 1st of December, and please join in with things that are going on. So let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. The Lord be with you. Christ, the Sun of Righteousness, shine upon you. Scatter the darkness from before your path and make you ready to meet him when he comes in glory. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, come down upon you and remain with you this day and forevermore. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. And we go singing our final hymn, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel.